the live stream Facebook Live. You are tuned in to the People's Baptist Church, located at 1539 Baltimore Avenue, Philadelphia, PA 19143, where yours truly, the Reverend Eric J. Good, is the pastor. We've come to remind you, as we do every Sunday, that God is in control and that God is available, and that if you trust and never doubt, God will surely bring you out.
Jesus! 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 Jes
the righteous they run unto, and they are saved. We bless the name of the Lord today. We certainly are grateful to those who are joining us via live stream. Again, you're tuned into the People's Baptist Church, where we come to celebrate the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Dear God, we thank you now for this moment. We thank you for your presence this day. Thank you for who you are. Thank you for your grace. Hallelujah. Now, dear God, as we come to worship you, we ask, my Father, now, that your presence will be felt this day. I pray that whoever is listening, that they would be encouraged, that they would be strengthened in their faith journey today. Pray that you would bless the proclamation of the gospel. We pray that somebody would be lifted today by the song and by the sermon. And ultimately, God, if it's in your will, add to the church those who should be saved. And we thank you. And we magnify you. And we glorify you. And we lift your name up. And we praise you. And we thank you. We give you glory. We give you honor. We give you praise. So we ask, dear God, that you will be with us. Strengthen us even now. And we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. All be blessed. God, thank you. Again, to those who are joining us via the live stream, again, thank God for each and every one of you who continue to share each week with us in these worship expressions. Do me a favor. Those who are watching me via live stream, do me a favor, so that others can be a benefit and can benefit from this worship expression. Why don't you go to their Facebook or go down to the screen and press share on your mobile device. Share this service so that others can be lifted and blessed by this worship ministry. I want to also extend, this is a day where we celebrate the deacons' ministry of the People's Baptist Church. Each week, every year, Sunday after Sunday, week after week, the deacons ministry, both male and female, they assist me in carrying out the work of the Lord here at the People's Baptist Church. And today, we salute the diaconate ministry of the People's Baptist Church. Thanks be to God. Hallelujah. The deacons ministry is led by our wonderful and illustrious chairman, that in the person of Deacon Ronnie G. Bundes. We thank the Lord for him. Praise the name of the Lord. We thank God for his ministry. And now, again, I always remind you, for those who are listening or watching me right now, we are always reminded and thank you so very much for your continued contribution to the work of the Lord, and continue to encourage you that you can do that continually. Your contribution helps us to continue to be what God has called us to be. And so again, I repeat again, you can send in your love donations to the People's Baptist Church at P.O. Box 19848, Philadelphia, PA 19143. That's again, P.O. Box 19848, Philadelphia, PA 19143. Or you can come in on Sunday and Wednesdays from 9:30 to 11:30. And our trustees, our trustful trustees, will be glad to accept your monetary donations. Or you can go to your screen, your phone, download the Giftify app, and certainly type in the People's Baptist Church. Type in the gift, hit donate, and it will come straight to us. And you will also receive a receipt verifying that your gift has been received. Once again, we thank you for your generous contribution to the work of the Lord. We also want to extend our sympathy and condolence to the Bond family, our sister Charmilla Bond, in the loss of her father, and sister Doris Bond, in the loss of her husband. And there will be a service of celebration, a memorial, which will take place on Tuesday, July the 28th, 2020, at 11 a.m. Again, a service of celebration will be taking place here. Memorial will take place here on July the 28th, 2020, at 11 a.m. Please look out for further information as well as instructions. Again, now we're going to be favored with two selections from our ensemble. They will bless us with the music, the minister of music, and after which we will come back with the proclamation of the gospel. Lord, we thank you that indeed we can trust you. Thank you, dear God, for your grace and indeed your mercies that have been extended in Christ Jesus. Now, dear God, as we proclaim the gospel, I pray that somebody will be lifted this day by the word of the Lord. We thank you now. In Jesus' name, amen. Psalm 27, I want to pick up where I left off on Wednesday. Psalm 27, those who are watching us via live stream, Psalm 27. Uh-huh. 13 and 14 will be the text, but I want to extract a few words from verse 13. Psalm 27 and verse 13. These words are recorded. I would have fainted. That's all I want to read. I would have fainted. Now I want to talk a little bit today. I want to preach from this thought. I would have fainted. I would have fainted. One of the common experiences is the feeling of exhaustion. This emerges when we are spent and tired. The feeling of being strained can manifest itself in various ways. There is Lamar fatigue and irritation. Those who experience exhaustion have the feeling of not being able to go any further. Being tired is not just something physical, but it comes from going through a plethora of situations. For those who are watching me now, you can testify like the lyrics of this song. Truth is, I'm tired. Options are few. I'm trying to pray, but where are you? I'm all churched out, hurt and abused. I can't think what's left to do. Many can attest and affirm that they have been close to giving up and throwing in the towel and wanting to faint. There are moments when we experience the frustration of life that comes from both people and things. Sometimes things and people will make you want to give up. Sometimes nickels and onions, I do despise nickels and onions, make you want to cry. Sometimes all of us, I submit, all of us will experience the feeling of frustration, and sometimes it is difficult to cope with this everyday life. This seems to be the sentiment of the psalm today. This is a rich and a reassuring psalm within the worship tradition of Israel. These psalms were composed to help guide the worship of the people of God. There is no identifiable historical connection of this psalm. Nevertheless, the psalm points to the reality of enemies who plot and scheme against the faithful. We are not told what occasioned this opposition, which is a reminder that faithfulness to God will often engender the fury of people. Let me tell you something. When you walk with God, you must always anticipate that someone will not like you. Let me pause parenthetically and quote Jesus for a moment. Beware when everybody speaks well of you. God, help me. There will be moments, brothers and sisters, those who are watching me via live stream, you will face opposition from friends, from enemies and frenemies. Let me say it again. You will experience opposition from enemies and frenemies. The enemies are those who are knowingly against you, but frenemies are those who can you. Watch what they have an agenda. God, help me to preach today. Watch this, brothers and sisters. Ladies and gentlemen, all of us will experience opposition. If you walk with God, then you have potential. Well, you are doing what God has called you to do. Everybody, there's going to be some haters in the game. There's going to be some Judases in the crowd. Father, can the church shout hallelujah? Nevertheless, this psalm, the focus of the psalm is on who God is, verse 1, and what God can do, verses 5, 7, and 10. In spite of his enemies, he talks about not just about his enemies, but he talks about who God is and what God can do. Essentially, the psalm acknowledges the presence and the plot of those who are against the faithful. In addition, it lifts our gaze above the enemies of the people of God. We must never allow the opposition of the enemies to blind us to what God, who God is, and what God can do. I don't care how many haters I've got in my life, it will never cause me to lose sight and focus on the God that I serve, because my God is greater than my enemy. Oh, I wish I could preach like I feel. I said, the God that I serve is greater than my enemies. Let me preach that one more time. I said, the God that I serve is greater than my enemies. Lord, have mercy. Thank you, Jesus Christ. This psalm shifts to a declaration in verses 13 and 14. Now watch this. The text is trying to teach us today that despite what we face, God is our deliverer. Oh, let me say that again. You didn't shout from those who are on Facebook Live. If you're wherever you are, you can shout on this point. The text as a whole is trying to teach you and I that despite what we face, despite the enemies and things, God is our deliverer. Now watch this. I don't care what you're going through, God can bring you through. Let me preach again. I said, despite what you're going through, the God that I serve has the power to bring you through. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The psalmist reflects on the possibility of fainting in adversity. Each of us have experienced a moment of exhaustion to the point of being disheartened. There was a feeling that life was coming to an end. Yet we have to ask the question of the psalmist. What kept you from falling? What kept you from fainting? Because notice what he says. Notice the language of the text. He said, I would have fainted. I would have fainted. Well, wait a minute, psalmist. What kept you from fainting? You had all these enemies against you. You had situations against you. People plotting on you. People lying on you. What kept you from stumbling? What kept you from giving up and throwing in the towel? What kept you from falling? And that's the question I venture to say that that's the question many of you are asking, not only of myself, but because you're asking that question now of your own self. And you gotta sometimes ask yourself that question. What kept me from falling? Because right now, the truth of the matter is I came close to slipping. I came close. Can I get a witness? I came close to slipping. I came close to losing my mind. I came close to cussing someone out. I came close to just throwing up my head and saying, I'm not tired. Deuces, I'm done. I came to a place where I was mentally exhausted. I was mentally drained. I was sick and tired of being sick and tired. But what kept you from falling? What kept you from fainting? And that's what you want to know, don't you? I'm sure you do. Let's get the answer and get out of here. Shout hallelujah. I got two things to give you, and then I'm going to put you on the body here. The first thing I want to tell you, this is what kept me from falling. This is what kept me from falling.
What kept me from fainting? Because I knew I would see God's goodness no matter the gloom. I said I knew what kept me from stumbling, what kept me from throwing up my head and saying I'm done, is because I knew I was convinced.
States the possibility of fainting or becoming disheartened. This portion is found in the King James and New King James only. Others' versions delete it altogether. The psalmist shares that there was a possibility of fainting, but yet had he not had the conviction that the goodness of God would be seen, experienced in the land of the living. This is our faith. Where did this come from? This came from a faith that flowed from having communion with God. You see, when you have communion with God, when you talk to God, God may not change your problem, but God will give you a different outlook, God, about your problem. I wish I had a church.
After enduring harsh treatment on the plantation, not the cross,
reflection, one of the effective voices and symbols of hope during slavery was the slave preacher. The slave preachers exhorted fellow slaves not to grow weary, to endure suffering, to endure ill treatment, knowing that hope was on the horizon. Slave preachers accomplished this through the creative use of oratory, scripture in imagery, unusual charisma, and rebellion against the slave system. Thus, the slave preachers provided the words and actions helped slaves embrace hope in the worst of times. Black preachers was able to help the people find hope in times of hopelessness. Today, we can find God in the midst and the crises of COVID-19. Indeed, we're witnessing the demoralizing of America. Things are bad, but God is still in control. God is still moving, and God will change the nightmare of this world into the dream of God. Can I get a witness? Can you just throw your hands up and say things are going to get better? Things are going to get easier? Yes! I got to close this, but I got one more point. I got one more shot I need to shoot. I'll be through here. The final point that I want to tell you, I didn't say because I knew I would see the goodness of God in the midst of my gloom. But there's one more reason why I didn't faint. I didn't faint so I could encourage others to persevere despite the problem. God help me to preach. I didn't faint because I needed to encourage somebody to keep on keeping on. Can I get a witness? Notice what he says. Wait on the Lord and be of good courage. And a strengthen thy heart. The song closes with an appeal to the community from a composer. One of the greatest challenges is to wait on God when things are at its worst. That's the greatest, and that's one of our challenges. Yet we are invited to rely on the Lord. Now, this is not mere inactivity. You're doing it, not just waiting on God, being lazy. But notice what the text says. In Psalm 27:11, he says, teach me your way, O Lord, and lead me in a smooth path because of my enemies. I gotta close my little sermon now. In essence, the Jew had to live according to the Torah. Oh, let me just make this make sense. That is to say that while you're going through, you gotta continue to live for God. Don't be discouraged. Don't give up. And don't just go live in any kind of way. But you gotta walk upright. I didn't say walk perfectly, but you gotta walk with maturity. I used to make little requests of my mother and father, and they would say, listen, you'll get what you want, but you gotta do what you need to do. You need, if you're gonna get what you want, you got to be studious in school. You got to do your stuff around the house and buy. My faith was that if I did what I said I would do, that my parents by and by would do what they said they would do. Oh God, help me to preach this. If we walk with God, our faith is in this, that God will do what God said God will do. That you gotta wait in hope. You gotta live with hope. Can I get a witness? No wonder Arthur Weezer says this. He says that here faith is the power which enables the faithful to endure the tension between his present affliction and his future deliverance from affliction. The faith which has been granted the poet by God in prayer is a faith which does not see and yet lives in confident assurance. All I'm trying to tell you is that right now, I may not have deliverance, but deliverance is on the way. I may be in my mess, but I'm going to come out with a new
I'm in the safety of the Lord. Because you remain in the safety and the security of God. You can experience, you be in despite the bad. And you can occur sometimes the whole dawn when all hope is lost. Hold on. Because I'm in his safety.
live stream to find security in God through Jesus Christ, to become a part of the family of God, to accept and bear, to trust Jesus for yourself. So in the comment section, why don't you say, I want to be a follower of Jesus, and we'll respond to you. Or perhaps you are already a follower of Jesus, but you want to reunite with this church. Just put in the comment section, I want to join this church, and we will respond to you. Come on and find security in this insecure world. In this uncertain time, you can find security in the God of your salvation. Listen, the invitation is open. Come on. Our song is going to sing it one more time. Come on. I'm in the safety.
It is a high. It is a high. It is a high.
Christ. The communion of the Holy Ghost. Rest one about you now, get some of you, brother Lord. May the Lord give you the peace. May the Lord keep you healthy. And may the Lord strengthen you during this week. In Jesus' name we pray.
Thank you.